full swing.
It wasn't what was planned, but ladies and gentlemen, what a great sport. Ladies and gentlemen, Bette Midler. Well done, Bette. Singing all the way through. Are you all right? Are you sure you're all right? Oh, come. They're coming over. The telly's coming over to us. Don't worry, we'll sort it out. We'll get that sorted out. Telly's coming. Well, get you sorted out. Telly's coming. Thank you very much. Something that gets people's juices running. The subject of the horoscopes and the subject of your stars. How many of you believe in horoscopes? How many follow your stars?
Yes.
How many think that the stars are absolute rubbish? How many people think that they are complete rubbish? You think they're rubbish, right? You can just come with me. Who thought they were a good idea? You did. Would you like to come along here as quickly as you possibly can? What's your name?
Louisa.
All right, Louisa, start off down here. What's your name? Emma and Louisa, join me. You like stand there, let me go around there. Quiet, please, quiet. To help them on this little expedition, we've got Jenny Powell and Dan Fowlson. Right, this is Louisa, and your name?
Emma.
Emma there, Louisa there. Jenny, why are horoscopes such a wonderful idea?
Well, because I really believe in them. You know your stars and everything, they always come true. Like today, for instance, my star said I was going to meet someone famous, someone popular, someone really handsome, but is he here yet?
Well, I think he's standing over here. Dan, why is it thumbs down to horoscopes?
Mate, a load of superstitious garbage, touch wood.
Okay, so it's your vote now. You are going to decide in Crinkly Bottom Speaks. These two here, Louisa and Dan, they believe that horoscopes are a load of rubbish. If you disagree with them, phone us now on 0891 800 311. But if you disagree with Jenny and Emma, who think that horoscopes are a good idea, it's 0891 800 322. Call us now and let's sort out one of those big arguments that goes on as to whether the stars mean anything. And you know what happens to the person who gets the most calls?
Uh-oh.
Did you bring a change of clothes?
I brought a coat.
You brought a coat. Go to the kitchen, continue discussing this. We've got two MTVs and one, well, one. We'll have you out there, Bette. Don't worry, Bette, this will be them. They're here to get you, Bette.
Hey, this is it!
What's up? No, come on.
Come on, this will do it, folks.
I know you're trying to do your best, but I'm sorry. We can't have that in the house.
I said
you're not coming through my front door with that.
What are you talking about?
No, I'm not. That's ridiculous. This is a lovely old house. I know, Bette, we needed to get you out, but I'm afraid I had to tell them that they can't come through the front door with that digger. Stupid man. Look what you've done. You've destroyed the most valuable, the oldest part of the house. What do you think you were doing? Hey, what do you think?
Hey, don't start with us. We're Power Rangers.
Yeah, all right, if you could just get on with that and just sort that out, please. Please, if you would. Give back my poppy. Well done, lads. Well done. I'll have that back. Thank you very much. Well done, boys. See you in a bit, Bette. Because Bette Midler is going to be the human cannonball. And now we are going to find out how you are voting in the great Crinkly Bottom Speaks. Just pop that in there a moment, will you? Right, break it up. Come on, let's have the update and see how your phone calls are going. Do you like horoscopes, or do you think horoscopes are a load of rubbish, as Dan and Louisa think? Here we go. Jenny and Emma, they think that horoscopes are the bee's knees. Oh, if it stayed like that, you would be going for a trip, and you haven't brought a change of clothes. So, these two think horoscopes are really not up to much.
Too vague.
0891 800 311 if you agree with these two. But if you think that it's Jenny and her partner, the villager, who didn't know this was going to happen, 0891 800 322. Your call, your vote counts. Excuse me. Sorry about that.
If you're waiting for us to tell you, the great astrology phone-in, let's find out. Do you agree with Jenny and Emma that horoscopes are good news? Or do you agree with Louisa and Dan that horoscopes are a load of bunkum? Who did you vote for or against? Here's the final result. Who goes... Oh! That's close. That is close, right, come on, own up, mount up, you can go down, okay. Yes, you've got the big moment.
Lovely,
right?
Welcome.
And Louisa, if you'd like to go in first of all.
Thank you. Didn't
bring a change of clothes, did you? No, but she brought a coat with her. There we go, and we have a special starry themed ride. Big moment there, Owen. Can you reach the... Oh, hang on. I'll give you... Oh, do you want the handbag
please,
left?
Please,
please. Oh, fuck. Mother's Day in Crickley Bottom, isn't it? Yes, you see, this is the point where we celebrate Mother's Day, and it's the chance for all the mothers in Crickley Bottom to get their own back for the nasty and naughty things that their sons and daughters have done.
For example, there's a villager here who is the laziest man in the world. Yes. He will sit watching Bolivian politics or Swiss cheese making rather than bother to get up to turn the set off. Isn't that so, Kenny Flett? Stand up. But what he did to his mother, he invited his mother to come and stay at his house, and he went out, bought rolls of wallpaper and paint, and got her redecorating the house.
Just the bathroom.
Yeah, just the bathroom. Just the bathroom. And she thought she was going to get a holiday. So just a moment. Just there's more. Pat Taylor, stand up. Hello, Pat. Now, Pat Taylor was looking after her mum's budgie, and she thought it looked cold and it was shivering, so she put it in the airing cupboard and suffocated it. Lied about it for 7 years until she eventually said, "Honest, Mum, it just fell off its perch." And so, where you sat down? Get up. Ladies and gentlemen, we need to know who is going for the first trip of 1996. Should it be Kenny, who had his mum decorating the house? What do you think? Yeah! Or should it be Pat, who suffocated the budgie? Yeah! Just breathe a bit of life into that, will you, please? Come on, Kenny. Come on, Pat. This way. Come on. Come on. Hurry it up. I'll take the vote from that.
Opportunity to start the new year, calling you guys. Lovely.
Oh, on behalf of your mother and budgies everywhere, enjoy yourself. Coliseum, now just hold it there. Kenny, we thought you really ought to do the honours on behalf of budgerigars everywhere. Go on, pull the handle. They give you a reprieve, you know. Oh, what am I talking about? Go on, do it, for goodness sake. In a Mother's Day retribution. Anyway, we got that out of the way. Just wanted to highlight it really ought to be him. Oh.
Are you on the way to the doctor?
No, not exactly. No, it's my research team, you see. They've been working on this new
scientists?
Thing.
Scientists?
Yes, Gunging, this
really?
Is called. Yes, yes. If you apparently consume this,
yes.
You can go on a trip round the Great House and the gunge doesn't affect you. Do you want to come to...
Yes.
Can I say hello
sure.
to them? Because you're into all things scientific, aren't you?
Research scientists,
yes,
you say.
There they are.
Marvellous. Mind you, you see, it's the consistency of the formula that dictates the accuracy of the results, you see. It's the experiment that counts. Ooh. No,
well,
it is. It's all in the experiment.
Yeah, all right.
Yes, hello.
Shut up.
Hello. Oh, what's that?
Well, that's just to give it a bit of...
What's that?
Pickled onion.
Pickled onion? I see. So I drink it, do I?
Yes, yes. One quick... Oh, she's a game girl. How's that?
Look,
how's that then?
Actually, it's not bad. I suddenly feel rather confident.
Oh, well,
yeah, but I think we should test it, don't you?
Oh,
do you think we should test...
Put her on the chip, Blondie.
I do!
Yeah.
Yes!
That's it.
Oh,
yes.
And the great experiment, could I ask the professors to stand up, please? And is it gunge and go? Is that the special experiment ingredient? Is it gunge and go? Or is it gunge guard? Or could it be gunge and shoulders? Come on, make it this week. Make it this week that you give us a call. Get to the phone. You could win a tremendous amount of money. Gunge and go. 0891 44 7771. She's trying to get away here. Put a 2 at the end if you think that it's gunge guard. And put a 3 at the end if you think that it's gunge and shoulders. Hello. What's sausage? Because we've got tomorrow's world coming alive with, oh, I nearly said the name of the product. The experiment.
The experiment. I think it's going to work.
Will.
Yes, it will work. Yes.
Let's see.
I'm convinced it will. First of all,
good luck. I've got bad news for you guys. It hasn't worked.
Yeah. It's not very good at all, in fact.
What are you going to do about it then?
Back to the drawing board.
I think back to the university with those two, Mr. Edmonds.
The thing that worries me, she really goes on and on about this soap powder being so good, and it doesn't seem to have done anything at all. I think I'll put you on spin cycle. That should sort it out. Lovely. Yes, good. We've got a gotcha. We've got a gotcha that is going to provide a tremendous shock for something. And in NTV, could you be the star of this week's NTV?
No, it's getting a bit out of hand here in Southampton. In the yellow box, we have Will Dalglish. He's from Whitley Bay, and he's a Sagittarius. In the red box, we have Catherine Saunders. She's from Bristol, and she's a Libra. Take it away.
Okay, Will, can you hear me, first of all?
Yes, Noel, how are you?
Yeah, great. And you know the game, you know how you play?
More or less.
Okay, you might opt out. You might opt out of this and not go for the money. On the other hand, you might want to look after your clothes and whatever. Anyway, good luck. You know it is sudden death. Catherine, can you hear me?
Yeah, hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Oh, yeah. Oh, the guns will look nice on that outfit. Okay, are you confident with this?
Yep.
You know that you've got to try and crack a code, tap away at the phone, and we will add up the value of all the numbers that you tap. Let's now bring them together, Will and Catherine, and here come the numbers that we're going to be playing with tonight. Numbers coming up now. There they are, and we will stop the numbers, and tell me what you can see. What can you see?
5783.
5783. Okay, now we go again and we're going to put them into a code, which is the code that you have to try and crack on the number cruncher. Away they go. And you should still be looking at 5783.
All right.
Okay. Good luck. Your time starts now. So, Will and Catherine. And Will is putting in a lot of nines to start with. He is obviously hoping to win a lot of money out of this. But if Catherine cracks the code first, that will have been to no avail. Catherine's taking it very slowly. Will, you're very close, Will. That was close. Will, I can tell you that was extremely close. Yes! Will's got £560. Will's there, Catherine. £563, Will. Well done, Will.
Thanks very much.
I think you should be chivalrous and just go and thank Catherine for playing along and allowing you to get £563. Oh, she lost out. Oh, I can feel a number cruncher couple coming on, can't you? Well, I think you should do the gentlemanly thing and just give Catherine a very nice go. Oh. £563, 150,000 calls logged in just 20 minutes. Let's have the result. Who is the dream decade? The 70s and 80s have decayed away. Representing the 60s is the one who gets away with it.
For me.
No, we have some marvellous people down here. It's very tropical. It's wonderful. On my red side, I have Justine. Thank you very much. I have Justine. She's a scientist. She's from Madrid and she's a Cancer. On the yellow side, we have Kevin. He is Mr. Kevin, hairdresser of Battersea, and he's a Leo. So let's get number crunching inside the boxes, please.
Let's go to it. Justine taking on Kevin. The hotline should connect through immediately. Kevin, are you able to hear me?
I am, no.
Good evening, Kevin. It's
good
very,
evening.
Very nice to have you there with your goldfish in your hand.
That's it.
Are you really a hairdresser?
No, I'm not.
No, fine. Okay. Well, do you know the rules? Are you comfortable about this?
I'm very comfortable.
You know that it's not against the clock. You're just playing against Justine, who's over the other side. Hello, Justine.
Hello.
Hello. Sorry about this, Justine. We have a slight problem in the house. People complaining that they got covered in cake. But never mind. You could get covered in something far, far worse if you don't actually tap this out fast enough.
I can't wait.
Now, are you playing tactics, Justine? Are you actually going to go for the large amount of money or a swift conclusion?
Definitely large amount of money.
Large amount of money. Okay. Kevin against Justine. Let's scramble numbers in. The numbers that we are playing with on the number cruncher look like this. Here they come. Right. Now, what are you looking at, team?
1539.
1539. We'll go again and make that into this week's code. It will have changed and you should still be looking at 1539.
Yep.
You are. Okay. The code is on the screen for us. Take it away. Go on. Just see how much you can win. And she is. Justine is going definitely for the money. And Kevin is going for the more cautious approach. Well, Justine, you're putting some serious money into there. And Justine, you actually had the right first number. And Kevin, you got the right first number. Kevin has the right first number. He has a correct first number, but that's wrong second number. A wrong second number, Kevin. Very good. Kevin's got the £200. Justine's got covered in her best syrup. And that's the number cruncher this week. Well done. And Jono. Jono. Oh, lovely. Jono.
Yes,
ma'am. Jono, I've got one of these for you.
Do that. You know, the machine weighs and counts the money faster than any bank can. It truly is a miracle. How do they do it?
I don't know how they do that, you know, because the machine, whatever. But I tell you something, I know exactly how they organise this little sort of trip around so that you can have a look at the house.
The whole house?
The whole house, yes.
Everybody's so pleased for me as well.
Yeah. We're all pleased for you.
Well, I see everything.
Yes, you see absolutely everything. She'll see everything. She'll see everything.
Sorry, what did you say?
How did I do that?
What, you mean after all that, you still don't know how it happened?
Look.
What a silly lady. The big 100 next week, don't miss it. Stars wall to wall. Joan Collins joining us on the 100th house party next week, live from Crinkley Bottom. We've also got a number cruncher going international. You could win the holiday of your dreams. NTV bigger than ever before. Could you be involved in it? And we've got a gotcha that I didn't tell you about because it's a multiple. It's the big, big party next week. Your invitation is here now.